The game may be over, but the Super Bowl 54 halftime show, still a hot topic. As I'm sure you know by now, two superstar women rocked it out. First up, Shakira. The singer celebrated her birthday by bringing down the house with her impressive dance moves and got the crowd all hyped up for Act Two. J-Lo, no surprise, also a huge hit, and pulled off some amazing costume changes. But were the performances a bit too racy? A lot of people talking about it. And I know our A-plus panel can't wait to weigh in. Let's bring them in. We're joined by Chasing News contributor Ilana Mugden back with us. Good to see you, Ilana.
Thanks for having me.
And Allison Young, Republican strategist. Good to see you, Allison.
Thanks, Bill.
All right, Allison, I'm going to start with you on this. There was a huge reaction.
Yeah.
I found one of the most interesting reactions from former presidential candidate Jeb Bush.
Yeah.
Saying, best halftime show ever. What do you think?
So Jeb Bush and Marco Rubio, who live in Florida and who have Latin Americans in their family, thought this was appropriate, that this is how the culture is in Miami, that it was great. I thought Shakira was all of that and what people expected. I thought Jennifer Lopez took it to a new trashy low. Shakira took Jennifer Lopez to school last night. She was talented, the singing, the dancing. Jennifer Lopez goes for a stripper pole and shaking her butt in the camera. Come on.
I thought both women had high energy and their performances were engaging. And, you know, as to J-Lo, she was on the stripper pole, but she wasn't doing anything particularly racy. Maybe it's a little bit of ageism and maybe it's a little bit of misogyny, because there are people commenting like, oh, there's 50-year-old women on stage.
Ilana brings up an interesting point, misogyny. Some people are saying exactly the opposite, saying this is the exploitation of women. I found it that, you know, we're almost dealing in reality now, that sex sells and people,
yeah.
You know, good-looking people, you know, gyrating and moving is something that's been selling beer for a long time.
And it's consistent with both of their brands, too. I think the people that produced the halftime show had to know this is exactly what was going to happen on stage. It's consistent with who they are as performers. One was tasteful, one was not.
Personally, I think Beyonce and Jay-Z disrespecting the national anthem was a little bit worse, but that's my opinion. Thanks, guys.